Well, it's 5 o'clock, October the 9th, 2019. Kept awake by this tone. It's increased in volume. I've changed my mic setting. I've got 3 mic settings, Zoom, which causes kind of a reverb, but it does pick up a tone. It picks up like a whistle, but it's not, doesn't translate the same as I hear it audibly. And it's much louder audibly. It's like a, when you swing a pipe round in the wind, and it makes that whistling sound, and then it oscillates. At the moment it's a constant tone. Earlier it was warbling, like the pitch oscillating. So I'm going to leave the setting, go out of the room for a minute and see if I can catch it on a different setting. I've got surround. I'll try that as well. And I can't, because I can't hear what the camera hears. Sometimes you pick up the sound when you zoom the mic. Other times, when the mic's, when the focus is zoomed. Because the zoom mic sort of reacts with the zoom on the lens. This is just a focus. It may focus on the sound, the only sound, and then hang on to it. So I'm going to leave the room and see if I can get a different result. Thank you. We know that from the Holy Word that Satan is before the throne of God and on the earth. He's got dominion on the earth. He's in the heavens, accusing the saints. Then it makes me wonder, why isn't he accusing against his own people? Getting away with murder. What are the saints doing exactly? Giving out gospel tracts. Kind of ironic. The Lord has rebuked these Satan. Psalm 2. Why do the heathen rage and the people imagine a vain thing? The kings of the earth set themselves and the rulers take counsel together against the Lord and against his anointed, saying, let us break their bands asunder and cast away their cords from us. That just says everything. The saints, the anointed, which means those who are saved. These people want, they're a hindrance to these people, this conspiracy, this body of conspiracy, who are against the Lord, openly against the Lord, and against this anointed. Let us break their bands asunder, cast away their cords from us. They want to get rid of these people. But they're restrained, they haven't got the power because of the Holy Spirit and the Lord, the sovereign God and our Saviour Jesus Christ, holding back this wickedness. Let us break their bands asunder. They can't wait to get rid of us so they can get on with their plans, their little game of risk, where they want to conquer, divide and conquer. He that sitteth in the heavens shall laugh, and the Lord shall have them in derision. Derision is mockery. It's just, David derided, had done a derogatory dance to one of his wives who was a bit jealous of, envious. So he derided her by clowning around and praising the Lord in a kind of foolish way. The Lord shall have them in derision, and shall he speak unto them in his wrath and vex them in his sore displeasure. Yet have I set my king upon my holy hill of Zion. So the Lord's been triumphant in the victory, and he's on the right hand of God. I would declare the decree. The Lord hath said unto me, thou art my son, this day have I begotten thee. So there's a prophecy of the Lord Jesus Christ. Ask of me, and I shall give thee the heathen for thine inheritance, and the uttermost parts of the earth for thy possession. Thou shalt break them with a rod of iron. It's his holy word. Thou shalt dash them in pieces like a potter's vessel. Be wise now, therefore, O ye kings. Be instructed, ye judges of the earth. Serve the Lord with fear and rejoice with trembling. Kiss the Son, that means repent, and believe, lest he be angry and ye perish from the way, when his wrath is kindled but a little. Blessed are all they that put their trust in him. That's the second psalm. I'm going to go to the second to last psalm. Because the Lord gives power, gives his authority to his anointed, his saints. Okay, Psalm 149, that's the second to last. That was the second, so that's not the first and last, but the second to last. Praise ye the Lord, sing unto the Lord a new song, and his praise in the congregation of saints. Let Israel rejoice in him that made him. Let the children of Zion be joyful in their king. Let them praise his name in the dance. Let them sing praises unto him with a tremble and harp. For the Lord taketh pleasure in his people. He will beautify the meek for salvation. Let the saints be joyful in glory. Let them sing aloud upon their beds. Let the high praises of God be in their mouth, and a two-edged sword in their hand, to execute vengeance upon the heathen, and punishments upon the people, to bind their kings with chains, and their nobles with fetters of iron, to execute upon them the judgment written, this honour have all the saints, this honour have all his saints, praise ye the Lord. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord, for your holy word and your truth and your light and understanding and wisdom that you grant your children to be able to know where what's going on and see in this dark world, this evil dark world. Right, what I think I'm going to do is try this in the bathroom because it's got more acoustics. So I'm going to move. Right, the acoustics might be better in here, so I'll leave it in here for a few minutes. see if I can change the mic setting. If you ever find yourself in the... Oh no, I can't change it. Let's stop it and try another setting. Right, that's on surround. If you find yourself in the time of the Antichrist, just wanna, and if you're the seed of Israel and you're not in your homeland, and you're gonna be hunted, and they're gonna be after you first. So if anyone finds themselves, doesn't matter what inheritance they are, what blood they are, your best option is don't take the mark of the beast, because anyone who takes the mark of the beast has condemned themselves eternally. And once you've taken the mark, that's an open rejection of God. And there's no excuse for you to say, oh, I didn't know about Jesus, I didn't know about God. Well, God's evident all around you. Your life is evident of a creator, the existence. And people have been wondering for years what the purpose of life is. Well, and people have known for years that God's true and faithful, and he's a creator. So if you find yourself in that period, your best option is to run for the guillotine. If you're lucky to get it, because you might be killed, murdered, before you get the opportunity. And if you're a seed of Israel, you want to be back in your homeland. And even there, people are going to be, two-thirds of the Jewish people are going to be slaughtered, which is a repeat of the tragedy that, you know, the world cries, oh, we never do that again. But history repeats itself because the problem hadn't been dealt with. It wasn't dealt with then. It just changed, it just morphed, wiped its face, and increased its power in furthering its cause. And the people who conquered it just became it. It just contaminated, infected the whole human race. And that power is still on the earth. And if you think the Jews today are in Israel are the people behind the conspiracy, I personally believe that both Sephardic Jews, Ashkenazi Jews, they are predominantly of Jewish heritage, of the seed of Israel. And they're in the minority, they're not the global powers, they're not the ancient Babylonian powers, they are just the children of Israel. People who have been persecuted and targeted, and they've just desired their rightful inheritance back. That's the land of Israel. If you don't believe that, read the Holy Scriptures, read the Promise, read Exodus and Numbers, and the giving of that land to those people. And then if you don't believe that that's true history, then who are these people? What's Jerusalem? And you know, it's the Holy Bible's given the history of all the races, the Arabs, all the different tribes going back through ancient history, which also recorded secular history. So you can't deny the fact. It's not Palestine, it's Israel. And in World War II, that's why, you know, that's why the Jews were singled out amongst Christians, weren't they? Amongst Protestant nations. They were the target, Protestants. People who were against the Roman Catholic order. And the Jews, they were the chief targets. And any person that they deem weak and sickly were a target. I'll get rid of them, you know, it's like purge. Let's purge the old, what they consider the dross, you know, purge the dross out of the human race. And then, you know, this is what I've just read in Psalm 2. These people, their mentality, they're evil. Thinking they're the elect, the righteous, you know, and these are everywhere. These are the dominant world, Gentile powers. How many countries are righteous? How many kings are righteous? How many governors are righteous? The Lord only knows. Excuse my stomach. I'm going to try one more setting. Right, the last one was focus. Surround. Now I'm back to Zoom. And I'll leave it for a few minutes and see what comes out. Right, let's bring all thoughts round to the Lord Jesus Christ. Just thinking, all the people who reject Jesus and they're going to spend eternity in the lake of fire. And the people who've done this, that's what they're going to get. They're not going to get it for a few years like I've suffered. My God, my Saviour, my God, my Lord, my Heavenly Father, Jesus Christ, is going to pour it on, not only fire, but nice little tones and sounds. And it won't be for a year, it won't be for 10 years, it won't be for 1,000 years, it won't be for 1,000,000 years, or 2 million, or 3 million, or 4 million, or 5 million, it'll be forever. You'll be getting that in your ear, while you reeve around in the flames, wishing you hadn't been born, wishing you believed. And how foolish will you feel for not repenting? So I'd like to just close. And I don't know if you know this about the simplicity of Christ, my God, my Saviour. He's given everybody the opportunity. And it is, I don't know if you know that this is in the simplicity in the Holy Word. You may not believe, so you may not even look. But it's so plain. I'm going to read a few scriptures. And I'll start at Luke 24. So the Lord's just appeared to, after his resurrection, he's appeared to his disciples and said unto them, thus it is written, and thus it behoved. Behoved means it caused great agony and anguish. It behoved Christ to suffer and to rise from the dead the third day, and that repentance and remission of sins should be preached in his name among all nations, beginning at Jerusalem. That was so, and I know because I've received it, and many others have too, so there's no excuse that you could receive it too. Verse 48, and ye are witnesses of these things, and behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you. I've received that promise, many have received that promise, and that's the gift of the Holy Spirit, the indwelling of the God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. But tarry ye in the city of Jerusalem until ye be endued with power from on high. And that was fulfilled. Let's go to another scripture. Acts 20. So this is Paul's up after the gospel was preached from Jerusalem at the beginning. It went out the gates. Paul the Apostle was converted and he preached, he was the Apostle, he was commissioned to teach the Gentiles of the ministry of the Gospel of Jesus Christ. And when the Gentiles heard this, they were glad and glorified the word of the Lord, and as many as were ordained to eternal life believed. Acts 20. Now I'm going to go to Acts 5 first. Acts 5:31. Him have God exalted, this is the Lord Jesus Christ, my Lord, not your Lord. He's everybody's Lord, but if you haven't received Jesus, the devil's your Lord. You don't know Jesus, so he's not your Lord. But he's my Lord and my God. Him have God exalted with his right hand to be a prince and a saviour, for to give repentance to Israel and forgiveness of sins. Acts 20, 21.
testify him both to the Jews and also to the Greeks, repentance toward God and faith toward our Lord Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of sins. So if you're a sinner, you want forgiven and the free gift of eternal life, this is what you need to do. Acts chapter 2, 21. And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. It's that simple. It's simple and easy to be saved, but it's very difficult to be a believer. I never realised how difficult, how much suffering that would entail, and I couldn't have possibly known it. But like the Lord said, if you're an army, you're going to invade a country, you've got to make sure you've got the money. You've got to make sure you can fully see it all the way through. But in hindsight, the Lord had helped me see it through, and I'm grateful that I made that choice, that I saw the Lord with all my heart and believed, and he answered and saved me. So if you're listening to this, that gospel, that outstretched love and mercy is on offer today. But if you pass it by, you've rejected the free gift of eternal life and the knowledge, the sure knowledge, and the good report that comes through faith by believing and receiving, and then continuing on in that belief that you've received, in that eternal life you've received. And then you can see it through to the end, and you can know that you're saved, know that the Lord is true, and he's in heaven on the right hand, and he's coming again. He's going to come and rescue his church. And then it's going to come the period of wrath, God's wrath, for being rejected. And those people are going to be at the hands of these people. And the Lord's not going to judge the world by righteous men. He's going to judge the world by wicked men. And they're going to just slaughter each other, or slaughter themselves. And I'm going to close that and leave these thoughts in the beloved name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
I'm just going to try it zoomed, because in the video it comes out as a whistle and it picks up the tone. It's constant at the moment, it's no oscillating, so I'm going to try zooming it. Now, if I was to go down to my local council offices, after not getting anywhere doing it through the proper channels, or going to the police, or writing to an MP or ombudsman, because I've done that with things in the past, and you don't get a response to letter, phone call, whatever. So if I was to react and go down to the council offices or any one of the councillors, get a device, a stealthy device, that's not hard to do. I've got an old microwave. I could turn it into a zap gun and cook them in their bed. I'd be arrested. If I was to get a tone, play it in their head, they would they'd be crying murder. If I was to go to 10 Downing Street and play a horn really loud, or get a stealth weapon and play a tone into the Houses of Parliament or number 10 Downing Street, I'd be arrested. There'd be a covert SAS team on me in seconds before I got there. If I was to go to Windsor Castle or Buckingham Palace, where the Queen was in residence, and do the same thing, again, I'd be arrested. It just shows the hypocrisy and these things happen to the minority. These people I perceive are careful to single out only a small minority that no one else is going to take any notice. And if those people are self-destruct and destroy themselves and they get rid of them through health consequences, because this affects your whole biology. These microwave energies are known to cause Alzheimer's, neurological damage, biological damage, and your body can't rest, and so you become ill. You need that REM sleep, you need that deep sleep. But thankfully, most nights I'm just zonk out. I don't even consider it, but there's times where it's just it's unbearable, and so it's almost like a torture. Oh, it could be worse, I know, but it's bad enough. Just consider how you would deal with it if it's happening to you. I'm not going to react like that. I'm going to return evil for good. I just invite people to hear the gospel, accept the gospel, seek the Lord, repentance and faith in Jesus Christ, that they may escape that eternal damnation, that eternal hell and torment, which is an unbearable thought for people. To think that people will go there, and that people that are now suffering, regretful, foolish, because they lived a life of self, a life of sin, a life of unbelief. They didn't see anything wrong with it. They didn't see anything wrong with carrying on going as they did before. Going to bed and ringing up a debt of sin. Adding to all the other sins in the world. That's the justice of God, that's the mercy of God stretched out today for people to escape that judgment, that holy God, that holy righteous judgment. No one's going to have a word to say, everyone's mouths are going to be stopped. Because when the Saviour appears, everyone's going to know, every knee shall bow. But the world's going to carry on unbelief, and they're going to believe the Antichrist, the deceiver. He's going to
however he appears, you know, he might come on the stage. I'm not so sure that's certain about it's going to be the UFOs, but alien invasion, but it may well be. And he could land on his, come down in his spaceship, walk out, and the whole world's going to worship him, thinking that he's come to save the planet or something like that. Or he's simply going to come up really well powered, full of the power of the devil, of authority of the devil, be able to perform miracles, and people will be marvel at him. People will worship him and think, oh, this is the answer to our prayers. So all the problems that these evil people are creating, he's going to come up and remedy them. He's part of the gig, he's part of the scam. He's the author of the scam. And that the author of the scam, the devil, is going to take residence in a man. I believe a Jewish seed, because of the prophecy of Daniel. He's referred to the wicked prince. Not only the seed of Israel referred to as princes. But that's a lowercase p, not a capital P, like the Prince of Peace, our Lord Jesus. A loving, merciful God, gentle, kind. Gentle in his mercy, hard as nails in his judgment, and easy. No one can conquer Christ. He's conquered them all on the cross, made an open show of them, put down all unrighteousness, exposed all that's evil. Exposed all the little corners, all the dark little secret recesses. He's conquered his enemies. Nobody could overturn him. And he triumphed on the cross. And coming out of the grave, and granting people that victory, granting people that knowledge, granting people that spiritual freedom, that spiritual sanctuary, while they remain a captive to this the devil's power, devil's authority on the earth. So if you're watching this video and you're not a believer, you need to be a receiver. Otherwise you're going to get destroyed by the deceiver. And the deceiver is more powerful than you. He's got lots of hands that are all joined together, but when you see him face on, you can't join the dots up, you can't see the association between different groups acting a gig, like loads of pickpockets on the street working a crowd, working a scam. And that's what's happening on the world stage, is a scam, working a scam, but all these ambiguous bodies that are all connected behind by association, layers and layers and layers, association, so they can conceal our identity. So you don't see the hands, you just see the movements and think that's natural, oh, that's just the way it is, that's the way it goes. But these people are cunning, it's like farmers, they plan. And they make long-term forecasts. Calculated, sit on their beds planning, guileful, deceitful and wicked. And that's who's driving this world, that's who's behind the powers. That's behind all powers. You can't nail it down to one single group, like bankers or even the Roman Catholic Church or the Jesuits. It's a combination of all these different components. you're joined together in that conspiracy, in that heart and that nature. And the author of that's the devil. People don't believe the devil. So the power, he's got power over their ignorance. They don't know it. They don't know any different. They don't want to know any different. They willfully remain not wanting to know. So the mass, the leaven, the fat lump, remains fat and exploitable. And that fat lump rolls on all the minority and vulnerable people. But there's hope, there's always hope. Could people come forth at the last hour? And that's my prayer. The Lord's got friends in high places. And there's laws overseeing the law. And there's other laws overseeing those laws. And so forth, up to the sovereignty of Jesus Christ. So the Lord's will be done. Not my will, but the Lord's will be done. So I can only hope. Trust it to the Lord. What will be, will be. I'm saved, so that doesn't mean I like being persecuted, but I have consolation. It makes all my suffering and the trial worth it. It's only for a small moment. But while I'm spending eternity in heaven, in the crash of all those little babies that have been murdered, had their heads crushed, I'll be looking after them in the nursery or something, rejoicing in their eternal life, loads of children, loads of brothers and sisters, loads of friends, in the presence and love of the Lord, the sovereign God. And spending God willing, 1,000 years in the millennial reign on the earth. An experience in the life I didn't have in this life, in this moment, in this time. In that time, it'd be different. The Lord would be driving. And I'd be granted authority. But these people, they'd be suffering in agony and torment, waiting for those to follow, for the final judgments at the end of the millennium, where all nations again will rise up against the Lord openly, and the seed of Israel, and then he slam them down. The devil will be cast into the lake of fire, the false prophet, where the false prophet will be, and the Antichrist, when their little plan goes belly up, and they realise they can't beat the Lord. It's insane, it really is insane. These people don't believe, so they don't know, so they think they know better. They believe a lie. They believe that Lucifer's God, God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit are unjust and unfair. They just want to hold you back, so you're captive. Well, that's complete nonsense. Lord grants you free agency. What he doesn't grant you is to go and do what you like, sin and hurt people. He gives you freedom to live your life righteously, not for sin, not for greed, not for power, but for love. And while it's today, it's to share that. Not for ourselves, not to, to experience abundance of life, but sharing the gospel, glorifying the Lord, doing what's pleasing to the Lord, not what's pleasing to us or ourselves.
our own selfish desire and our vain ambitions, our bucket list. But to live for God, live for Christ. So, this suffering is worth it. That doesn't justify it, and that's not, I don't welcome it. I'm a human. I've got rights. Just because I say I'm saved, it doesn't give people a green light to persecute me. But people hate you without, of course, because they hated the Lord. The world hates Jesus Christ without cause. He's a byword of his word, like the Jews. It's October the 9th, 2019. I can hear the tone faintly outside my, just outside my back door. So I don't know where it's coming from. It sounds like it's coming from all directions. I don't know what's causing it. What I like to consider, if I can hear it, then the whole neighbourhood can hear it. I've asked my neighbour directly next door, denies hearing it. I've asked other people, just a few, they deny hearing it. Which is a bit odd. They're either lying, or they don't want to say anything. I don't know if I'll be able to pick it up outside. I don't want to be a conspiracy theorist, but in the world we know that there's Freemasonry, you have corruption, you have the Illuminati, the Synagogue of Satan. So you can only wonder in the Great Tribulation what sort of things people can expect. Torture. It's going to be a virtual world of like a mousetrap, like a net, a virtual prison. Like the purging, the film The Purge. You can have people going hunting people. All the nightmares you can imagine. People targeted, singled out, hunted down amongst the ignorant masses. You've taken the mark, who are perhaps on a virtual nationwide biotech online beast system, and you can't escape it once you're on it. And it seems the capabilities already in place. We know the beast that was, that is, and that will be is still on the earth, but it's not in a seat of authority. You think when Adolf Hitler got up and running into power, got voted into parliament and become the chief commander of his nation, then the Jews were openly beaten, persecuted, murdered. But before he got into power, it was done under wraps, it was done secretly. That's where the Gestapo got the phrase for gaslighting and gang stalking. It's a repeat. So we're definitely approaching another move by the Antichrist, by the devil, the One World Order, whatever you want to call it, Synagogue of Satan. It's a correct term. All those people involved in a conspiracy against God, against his people, and against all mankind to rule the world, take charge. They've got all the toys, all the satellites. High altitude satellites, drones, space satellites, and now all this 5G network equipment being established, being unfolded. And 5G is going to fill all the little crooks and crannies of radiation. And then you map that radiation and plot it on a computer. You can see everything everywhere, all at once. I'm thinking of that on the cell towers up at my local community. There's, I'm shivering. There's a sign, any place, anywhere. That's the name of their company. You know, it could be them. I might have hacked them off. I'm hoping I can catch it up, catch the tone from outside. Well, I'll see if that's captured anything. Thankfully, I can capture it because it's evidence. Not that our evidence is going to ever go anywhere, but I mean, at least people will be aware. And I know what my local council's like. It's not run by a local council, I can tell you. And people may find that hard to believe. But when you've been denied so many things, you know, to make a complaint, you need two witnesses. They're only come out after two witnesses. It's like the police, you phone the police. Oh, we've got to wait for another witness. There's a violent mob. Gonna beat me up, but no. Oh, we need ring back. We need two witnesses. It'd be the same with the council. The council didn't do anything while housing association walked all over us. They just grin. They just step back and do nothing. So then it's down to you to go and get support. Then you got, and there's no support available. So heads up, this is what's being rolled out. And I wonder how close we are to snatching away at the Church of the Body of Christ. And what's really afoot, because we see darkly, I don't know what these things mean or where it's coming from. Who's on the end of it? And how many other people this is happening to? You know, it keeps me awake at night. I don't see any other lights on around the estate. It's pitch black. So, something afoot. It is bizarre, to say the least. Is it, I wonder if it's like a community project to see if anyone complains. And maybe people have complained and got nowhere. And just keep their mouth shut. Maybe that's a social experiment, just to see what people do. I can't remember the name of the social experiment by, what's his name, Stanley, the Jewish gentleman. I think it was to stand on a street corner and ignore people, and then measure the reaction of the response. I wonder if it's something like that. So play a tone or something and wait to see if anyone says anything. Or it's like the electric shock. Where they shock people. And they're just told to follow the instructions. And there's no authority figure, so they just follow orders, like blindly. One after the other. And no one says anything or is concerned about the person being shocked. They just carry on going like robots. And if they're testing to see people's reaction, they go, oh, we can get away with this, we can get away with that. And if there's no one complaining, on it goes. Right, that's enough, I'm freezing.